openly. The Bible says once again, who will be all that our conversations in the past times with the lust of the flesh, the fulfilling of the desires, who fulfilling the desires of the flesh of the mind. We thought the way we did things with our bodies, with things we weren't supposed to do, and some of us out there are still doing things with our body we weren't supposed to do, and heading straight to damnation. Now I'm not judging, I'm just telling you the truth, the whole truth and nothing but the truth. The word of God is telling you right here what you're doing. We were all fulfilling the desires of the flesh in the mind, who are by natures are children of wrath, even are others. But God, who rich in his mercy. Come on, somebody. I'm going to bring you up out of your distraction. God in his mercy, in his rich in mercy and great love, wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in our sins, when we were distracted, he quickened us together with Christ. By grace you are saved. I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, this is called our second version. We did our second part of Distractions. I just want to thank my good friend. Hadn't talked a long time with Pastor Swilly over there in Virginia, I believe. And had a good time talking with him. He's a mighty man of God, powerful man of God. And I enjoy talking with him. He's a great friend of mine. I also want to tell my good friend, Pastor Pearson. Hadn't talked to him in a while. He's always pushing me in a direction, giving me good wisdom and knowledge about things that's going on around in the very body of Christ that we can all learn from. But I tell you, man and woman, God, it's nothing short of what God declared all of us to be and come a part of. We all got to be able to come together and be as one, to know that is not no weapon. That's not nothing that's formed against us should prosper. That's what the word of God tells me. We got to believe and declare and decree that whatever it may be going on in our life, we got to know that God is more able to bring us out of whatever is going on. I am Pastor Charles Ellis here at Harvest Life Church and Harvest Life Studios. You have been now listening to, or you just finished listening to, the Word of God Dealing with Distractions Part 2. And this is a 3-week series we're going to be dealing with. And I want you guys to send your response, send your letters. Don't be ashamed. You know, to be a follower of Pastor Ellis, there's nothing wrong with that. Don't worry about what your critics say. And if you love the word of God that's coming forth, hey, be a follower of Pastor Ellis. I'm doing a good word over here. And I thank you guys for your prayers. I thank God for my good friend out there, Pastor Albright from Ghana, and my other friends, Emmanuel out there from Ghana, Lagos, Nigeria, from being a part and listening on tonight. And I thank God for each and every one of you as you continue to go forth and hear what the word of God has to say. Remember the word of God said that he who has an ear, let them hear what the Spirit of the Lord has to say that's coming to the church.